El don se tiene un nuevo ritmo, ritmo que tiene mucho sabor. Corre y avísale a tu vecino, corre, sintoniza el televisor.
Ya llegó,
llegó,
ya está aquí,
ya está aquí.
Ven pa' que lo goce con el ritmo del 12.
Ven pa' que lo goce.
¿Qué tal, amigos? Bienvenidos a este su programa Ritmo del 12. Hoy nos encontramos, como pueden ver, en los terrenos de agricultura, donde estaremos aprendiendo un poco más sobre esta fruta maravillosa que a todos nos encanta, el mango.
That's right, Adriana, it's early in the summer season, and of course that means mango season. And today we have an expert with us today who's going to talk to us about the taste, texture, and of course the sweetness of this fruit. But most important, what sets them apart.
Sí, amigos, hoy no solo aprenderemos los diferentes tipos de mango, sino que también los tendremos en nuestra cocina. That's right, today we're going to learn how to make some recipes with this marvelous fruit.
And if that's not enough, you'll have to get your fill of mangoes at the premier event on St. Croix, El Mango Melee. Para detalles, luego en este programa. Amigos, lo prometido es deuda y nos encontramos con el comisionado asistente del Departamento de Agricultura para hablarnos un poco, ¿verdad?, sobre todos estos mangos que tenemos aquí, el señor Errol Chichester.
Sounds good.
Saludos.
Buenas.
How you doing?
Bien, ¿y tú?
Muy bien, muy bien, muy bien. Hablo un poquito español, ¿eh?
Sí. That's it. That's all I know.
Well, we are glad to be here with you today for you to take the time to teach us a little bit about the different varieties of mangoes. Because, you know, since we're kids, we'll be eating mango, but we had no idea the difference between one another unless something gets stuck on our teeth. So can you please tell us a little bit about the different types of mango?
Absolutely. Well, you may or may not know that mango originated in India.
Ah, and el mango se originó en la
I
India.
Had no idea. No okay. Sabía que se originó en la India.
Right. And in India, there are thousands, not hundreds, thousands of different varieties.
Miles de variedades en la India.
Okay. And in the Caribbean, we've been consuming mangoes, as you said, for quite a while. And many of us really don't know that they are locally grown in the territory in the Virgin Islands, over 100 different types of mango.
Wow. Bueno, sobre 100 distintas clases de mango, en las Islas Vírgenes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, when I said mango varieties, I'm talking about named varieties, mangoes that have names.
Mangos, o sea, que tienen nombre. Cada variedad tiene su nombre.
Okay. There are, in addition to over 100 named varieties, you also have numerous varieties, if not more than 100 of unnamed varieties.
Wow, en adición a los 100, a las 100 variedades
tiene
que tienen nombre, hay otras variedades que no tienen nombre todavía.
And let me tell you how the unnamed varieties come about. For example, this mango in my hand now is called Hayden. So if you plant 10 seeds from this Hayden mango, you could get 10 different varieties.
No.
Si, okay, si siembra, wow. Si siembra 10 semillas de este tipo de mango, puedes cosechar 10
diferentes
variedades.
¿Sí? And if you plant 100 here, you could get 100 different classes.
Y si siembra 100, le saca 100 distintas variedades.
Why
wow.
Is that? Do you...
Okay, right. Now, it seems as though you want me to go into the science part of it.
Yes.
Mango...
Briefly.
Mango has got two types of mangoes. One we call polyembryonic.
Hay dos tipos de mango, el embrio y pólico.
Okay, and the one is called monoembryonic.
Y monoembriónico. Uh-huh.
Polyembryonic are mangoes like kidney.
Oh, como kidney mango.
Okay, uh-huh. With a polyembryonic, if you plant a seed, you'll get the same mango. Like manzana and kidney, if you plant those seeds, you will get the same type of mango.
Okay. Si siembra esa misma semilla con ese tipo de semilla, en la poli.
However, if you plant the monoembryonic type, which Hayden is, you get a different type of mango.
Si siembras la mono.
Interesante. Se obtiene diferentes tipos de mango. Qué interesante.
And that's why, especially with these monoembryonic mangoes, we tell folks, persons will say, if you have a big mango like that, and they would say, this is a nice big mango, I want a tree like that, and they would say, let me save the seed. Saving the seed does not guarantee exactamente. We will not give you the same mango.
No te va a dar el mismo mango, aunque guardes la semilla. Para obtener el mismo mango, no lo vas a obtener porque varía al crecer la planta. Very interesting. I mean,
to get the same type of mango, if you're interested in this big one, which a lot of people are, I am one who prefer some of the smaller, nicer tasting mangoes. So to get any particular variety that's mono-embryonic, you will have to propagate the mango trees by a process called grafting.
Grafting.
Hay un proceso.
Que se llama grafting.
Exacto.
So what, I think it's injecto.
Un injerto.
Yeah. See, my Spanish is...
Okay, muy bien, un injerto. Un injerto es cuando mezclas una con otra.
Okay. Okay.
Again, planting from seeds, if there's a particular mango you're interested in, don't waste your time planting from seeds. Especially if it's mono-embryonic, because you're not going to get the same thing.
So you have to do it by the stem.
Exactamente. Mm-hmm. Okay, which we call... vegetative propagation. I'm going to show you that. Uh-huh. But so we have lots of varieties of mangoes on St. Croix, and they all have different size, different taste, different texture, different color, different uses. Some mangoes are better for eating out of hand. Some mangoes are better for making juices. Some mangoes are better for making tarts and pies and jams and that type of stuff.
Cada mango tiene un gusto distinto. Se puede utilizar para distintas mezclas de lo que usted quiera hacer con el mango.
Qué rico, ¿no? What's the name of this one, actually?
Piñero.
Piñero.
Sí.
Piñero.
Sí, grande.
So, mango piñero. In my country, we call it manga because it's so huge.
Yes.
It's a female... Voluptuous female mango.
Yeah, so this is one of the biggest mangoes we have in the Virgin Islands, and this is a small one.
Ah.
They get twice the size.
Wow.
Piñero.
That's a small one?
Yes, sí, señor.
Permiso. Ese es uno de los pequeños. Vienen más grandes todavía.
Sometimes they get twice the size. And
wow.
Piñero is one of the biggest mangoes that we have locally.
So the flavor does change.
Yes.
The difference between this one and this one in taste, would this be sweeter?
I, for one, tend to prefer smaller mangoes. For me, they're much sweeter.
Okay.
I wouldn't...
So, más grande no significa que sea más dulce.
Más dulce, no.
Sí, va a tener más carne, más pero pulpa, no sí, significa yes. que sea más dulce.
And, you cannot describe the taste of a mango. The individual has to taste the mango to determine the taste. Because it's not only about taste and sweetness, it's also about aroma, aromatic flavor.
Mm-hmm.
There are some mangoes that you eat, and you could smell it through your nostrils,
yes.
you could through your
yes.
palate. It, mm-hmm. So you describing a mango taste is illegal.
Describir el sabor del mango es un poco difícil porque depende, ¿no? De la textura
sí.
y del sabor.
Es como cuando uno va a un restaurante a comer, when you go to a restaurant to eat and you, the fragrance of the meal and
yes.
the taste and the texture, everything
yes.
is just an experience.
Right. Now, one of the mangoes that's grown throughout the Caribbean and is preferred, is very light throughout the Caribbean from Trinidad all the way up to Jamaica, is Julie. Pequeña. Okay.
Julie.
Este mango se da desde Trinidad hasta Jamaica.
Sí.
En el Caribe.
Yes.
So only to the Caribbean? Solamente al Caribe.
It grows in Florida too, but this is the preferred mango. When you hear anybody from the Southern Caribbean or even up to Jamaica, you hear them talk about Julie because it's a preferred mango.
El mango preferido se llama Julie.
Julie. And it's all right.
Juliana, qué mala eres. Qué mala eres, Juliana.
Okay. Now, this is a mango called Forbes. And those persons in the community who knew Mr. Amadale Forbes, he was a local farmer that developed, well, he didn't develop. He planted a particular seed, and this mango was derived from the seed that he planted, so then he could go ahead and name this mango Forbes by his name.
Oh, very
qué bien.
Nice.
Explícale.
Bueno, este personaje plantó esta semilla específicamente para él nombrarlo, ser la primera persona en nombrarlo.
So it's a very sweet mango. It's a very nice mango. So this is a
nice
local.
This, mango.
This is a local. This is a local variety that was created, for lack of a better word, here on St. Croix.
Una variedad local que fue creada aquí.
And I tell you what, you could have this one.
Uh-huh. they all smell differently? They have different aromas?
Different aroma, different taste, different texture, different sweetness.
Huelen distinto, la textura es distinta, sabor es distinto en las distintas variedades.
Okay, so all these beautiful mangoes that you're seeing here, and you can see the varied color in terms of, this is just a bland yellow mango, small.
Mango, regular.
Regular.
But you taste it.
Pero. Bien dulce, blandito.
Dulce y blandito.
Okay. Azucarita.
Uh-huh.
Azucarito.
Azucarita.
I'm not going to
Spanish. Está dulce.
I tell you what. Of all the mangoes here at the Department of Agriculture, when I go into the mango orchard, this is the mango that I go to. Mm.
De todos los mangos.
Ese es el que va en una acción, en una opción. Ese es el que él escoge.
It's a beautiful mango. All of this big, colorful mango, I personally don't care for them. Okay, so this is, and my favorite, ladies and gentlemen, is Carrie. Carrie is a beautiful mango. Okay, so this is Carrie. And then we have a mango that originated, I would think, in Jamaica. It's grown in Jamaica a lot.
Aparentemente se originó en Jamaica.
Very nice mango, too, small but sweet.
Dulce, pequeño.
No strings.
No tiene
no fiber.
No
fiber.
Fibra.
Okay, it's called Bombay.
Bombay.
Small, not very colorful, but very nice mango. Okay.
I'm going to keep this one on this side.
Oh, yeah, you can keep the camera. That's fine. Okay. This mango is a very colorful mango. This one is Tammy Atkins.
Parece un corazón.
¿Cómo se llama? What's the name?
Tammy Atkins. TOMMYATKINS.
Tommy.
Tommy Atkins.
Tommy Atkins.
This particular mango, you could play baseball with it.
¿Cómo?
Play basketball with it.
Puedes jugar pelota, baloncesto.
And turn around and sell it. Is that firm?
Y venderlo.
Is that firm?
Wow.
It travels well. It has a long shelf life. But in my opinion.
Well, I can tell the difference just by el aroma.
Sí.
This one is very strong, very nice. Makes you want to eat it.
Yes.
I keep looking for the one in this one. It doesn't have any.
So Tamiya, and they get much bigger than this. This mango gets up to 2 pounds, 3 pounds.
Wow.
Okay.
What's the biggest mango you've ever weighed?
Piñero. Piñero. Up to 5 pounds.
Up to 5 pounds?
Up to 5 pounds.
5 libras de mango en uno. Wow.
Okay. So, this is another mango. This one is Smith. Lovely looking mango. They get a little bigger.
Smith.
Look at those Smith. Colors.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Colors are beautiful.
Tiene pecas.
In my opinion, again, in my opinion, this mango is...
No,
just my preference now.
Ah, bueno, claro, es que a la preferencia de él, no lo convence mucho.
Okay.
Also don't have a smell.
Okay, so this is another mango here. This one is called Irvin, I-R-W-I-N. Okay. Between that and Hidden, I think these are the most beautiful looking mango. Look at this mango, all the way around.
Él entiende que dentro de todas las clases, ese es uno de los más preciosos.
This is what I call a diabetic mango.
Mm-mm. Oh!
Mango diabético.
Because it's not sweet.
It's not very sweet.
No dulce.
It's not very sweet.
Bueno,
but it's a lovely looking mango. I mean, if you go to the supermarket and you see a mango like that, you will want to purchase it. I-R-W-I-N, Irvin.
Muy bueno, para los diabéticos y el que estén en dieta también, ¿verdad?
And no strings.
Uh-huh.
And this mango,
no
could
tiene
peel,
fibra.
You could peel them, dice them, freeze them for later on. As you know, during the mango season, we have lots of mango. We have an abundance of mango. However, after July, August, the number decreased significantly. So those of us...
Después, o sea, de que después de julio y agosto, la producción de mango baja.
Yes.
Yeah, so we could extend
the life of the fruit
by freezing. And mango freeze very, very well.
O sea, se puede congelar.
Sí.
Y de esa manera extiende la vida.
Después, en el futuro, sí.
Okay, so now, here we are. As you can see, this mango is totally different in shape. It's more kidney shape and it's long. This is a beautiful mango. And not
I
only beautiful...
Those as a young boy.
You sure it's the same one?
Yes. No, well, no, I'm saying... well, they look similar, the shape of it.
Okay, so this mango is called Valencia Pride.
Valencia.
This mango is muy bueno.
Mm-hmm.
Cualidad especial.
Calidad especial.
Especial, okay. Is my Spanish good?
Sí, muy bueno.
Very good. Okay, this mango, the quality, the taste, the texture.
La calidad, el sabor, la textura.
No fiber.
No tiene fibras.
Flavor and aroma, beautiful.
El sabor, el aroma, fantástico.
Excelente.
Excelente mango.
Mm-hmm.
Mira, bueno, Adriana, usted
yo,
que...
Yo
tú quieres la bueno...
Bueno,
loca.
Por fuera no me huele.
No.
No, este sí.
But, and this one is not fully, it's a, this one is not fully ripe, so you're not getting the full fragrance.
Okay. No está maduro todavía.
No está maduro.
Okay. No está maduro.
And then we have another mango.
Yeah, that one.
This is a recent introduction to the Virgin Islands. This one is called Cogshall.
C-O-G-S-H-A-L-L.
Cogshall. Yes. This is a new introduction into the territory, and it's also a very beautiful mango, nice tasting. Most of these varieties of mangoes that we've seen here, they have very little fiber.
Mm-hmm. Muy beautiful. Poca fibra entre todos los mangos que ven aquí.
Okay.
How many different classes do we have?
Very good. On the Department of Agriculture, the orchard behind us, we have at least 40 to 45 different varieties of mango.
Right here.
Right here.
Wow.
However, there is over 100 named varieties, mm-hmm. as I indicated, grown here on St. Croix. And again, we recommend that persons who are interested in a particular variety don't save the seeds and plant the seeds. Have the tree grafted.
Correct.
Okay, aparentemente hay sobre 48 distintos tipos de mango sembrados aquí en agricultura. Pero estaba explicando ahora lo último que dijo.
Que tiene, hay cientos acá, 100 que ya tienen nombre, 100 que por allí no tienen, pero si usted quiere uno en particular, que a usted le gustaría y está guardando la semilla, no guarde la semilla, no. Porque la única manera de conseguir ese mango específico que usted quiere es bajo injerto. Usted tiene que aplicar un injerto, which you're going to explain to us how to...
Absolutely. Right? So, as we indicated, I just want to make it clear of some of the benefits or advantages for grafting.
Mm-hmm.
And the one that I mentioned, what's one of the benefits for grafting? You guys in class know,
mm-hmm.
what's the response?
That way you can get the mango you want.
Exactly.
Muy bien.
Exactamente.
Tiene una.
Very good. So that's one of the benefits. And that's the primary benefit you get. Identical, the same mango you're interested in.
El beneficio del injerto es...
Que puedes obtener el mango que usted quiere.
Exacto. Okay. Another benefit is that you obtain a tree at a very early age that will produce fruit.
Okay.
Wow, o sea que así puede tener un árbol que a temprana edad ya puede producir, fruta, sí, una manga, una mata de mango.
If you plant from seeds, it could take you 5, 10, 15 years before you harvest
wow.
fruits.
Wow. Si siembras la semilla, te puede tardar 5, 10, 15 años en lo que produce la fruta.
Sometimes more.
A veces más.
However, with grafting, you could harvest fruits anywhere between 3 to 5 years from the tree. So you have early production.
Con el injerto se tardaría de 3 a 5 años, más o menos.
Okay. Wow. So those are some of the two primary benefits. A third benefit is that it's easier to harvest.
Eso son dos de los beneficios. And it would taste the same, it would be the same mango, everything.
Exactamente.
So it doesn't matter, de 3 a 5 o de 5 a 15, it's the same mango.
Same mango.
Y usted puede tener sus mangos de manera más fácil porque el árbol no es tan alto. The tree won't be so big.
The tree will be big over time. However, it starts producing very early.
Empieza a producir temprano.
So what I'm going to show you now is how to do grafting. And I'm going to use a very simple process called a wedge grafting. W-E-D-G-E, wedge grafting.
Wedge.
Which, eso significa, that means the cuts?
The cut, it's like a wedge.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's a very simple.
Depende del corte que se haga, exacto.
Okay. So then, you need a couple things. You need first of all, a grafting knife. You need a grafting rubber band. And this is not a rubber band that you use for your office and that type of stuff. This is specifically for grafting.
Eso es específico, esa gomita.
Específica para el injerto, para injerto. Crear injerto.
Claro. Sí. Okay. And you need a small plant. And then you need piece from the desired tree, the mango you're interested in.
Okay.
Necesitas el árbol que tienes más un pedazo del árbol que estás buscando.
So,
Now this is the part where the leaves, the yes. ending of the leaves.
Yes, the ending of the leaves, the tip of the branch.
Uh-huh. The tip of the branch.
La punta del gancho.
Sí.
Normally, you would want what we call the eyes, the buds to be swollen, and that way the mangoes will send new shoots very quickly.
Okay, básicamente buscando de que el ojo, como le llama, que esté algo inflado.
Sí, porque así cuando se crea la conexión se envía alimento hacia esa área. So the food, when the food, the plant creates the food, it send it to it.
Exactamente.
And then the leaves rapid, will grow rapid. Rápido. Sí.
Okay. So this is my small tree. We're going to cut the top off. like that. So then, and as I said, this is called a wedge graph. So what we're going to do is make a cut straight on the middle.
Van a cortar justo en el medio de la planta.
Okay. And then this is the scion.
Y luego.
This is the rootstock.
Uh-huh.
And then this is the scion. And then we're going to make a cut on one
Al
side.
Al scion le van a hacer un corte en ambos lados.
On the other side. This is what is called a wedge graph because this is a wedge.
Uh-huh. Y ahí lo va a injertar.
Okay, good. You insert this wedge
in the middle.
In the middle.
Se coloca en el medio del tallo.
And then what you do, you take a grafting rubber band.
La goma que es específicamente para creada para injerto.
And then what you want to do is just go ahead.
No es una goma de oficina. No es una
oficina.
Enrollan, lo enrollan alrededor del corte para unir.
And you tie your connection.
Amarra de arriba abajo.
Para mantener la conexión bien unida, hacen el nudo.
Okay. Now, what will happen, the two will join. And then the new shoots will come from the top. And this is now your grafted tree in hecto.
El injerto.
Fácil. Eso mantendrá la humedad dentro
del scion.
Scion.
Y evitará que el agua entre a donde se hizo el corte del injerto. Porque si entra el agua al corte del injerto, pues se va a dañar la unión, que se espera que se solidifique.
Now, the tree that I took the scion from
el árbol,
is an urban.
Urban. Ah, sí.
Okay, so el árbol que sacó el scion, el corte del gancho, es un
urban mango.
Urban.
So when this tree produces fruit, it's going to produce me
urban.
It doesn't matter what's to the bottom.
Amigos, gracias por habernos acompañado. Tenemos más, así que no se vayan. Thank you so much for sharing all your knowledge with us. This has been wonderful. I know a lot of our viewers are going to be trying the grafting very soon.
Thank you, Assistant Commissioner. Your Spanish is very good.
I'm sí. Trying. Thank you very much. Gracias.
Continuamos en breve.
Bueno, amigo, ahora que ya sabemos los diferentes tipos de mango que existen en la isla, es hora de aprender. ¿Qué recetas podemos hacer utilizando estos diferentes mangos que se encuentran en nuestra isla? It's time to know what we can do with the different type of mango we can find on island. And for that, we have, of course, the genius chef, Andus. How are you today?
Wonderful.
And what can we do? What are you doing
well,
today?
Well, you know, I think everybody knows what a mango is, and everybody eats a mango either right, you know, hand to mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And then when it comes up to making things with mango, we kind of get lost because people always call me and ask me, what can I do with mango? So I want to show you a few things today. So the first thing I'm going to do real quick is I make an unbaked cheesecake, real simple. Goes in a glass, can go in the refrigerator. It's really healthy. It's low in carbohydrates. It's high in protein. A little bit of sugar from the mango. We're not going to add much else to it. And put it in the fridge, and the kids will actually eat it, and they have dessert, so no candy.
Muy bien, como ya escucharon, vamos a preparar primero, o él va a preparar primero, un mango cheesecake, que no necesita ser cocinado en el oven, pero en la estufa, y que los niños pueden comer, es bajo en carbohidratos. La única azúcar que se utiliza es la del mango, así que vamos a ir por el proceso con él.
All right,
so what do we do first?
So the first thing we want to take about a half a cup of water.
Media copa de agua.
Right, and we add one little gelatin package.
Okay, una pequeña, right. Un pequeño sobre de gelatina sin sabor.
And because I said one, I usually put a little bit more. I'm a chef. So all we do right now is we're basically just going to go and dissolve the gelatin in the hot water. And once that is done, we're going to the blender. So the next thing we want to do is we want to put in about two cups, and bear with me when I say two cups again, I'm a chef.
Okay, dos copas de mango.
Right? And the mango, basically what I did, we took the soft ones, you know, the ones that nobody wants to eat.
Las que son bien maduras, el mango right. Muy maduro.
So we have cream cheese.
8 onzas de queso crema. ¿Usted sabe cuál es el queso crema? Ese que se usa bien rico con
right. We got that so far? Pretty good, huh?
Ahora lo licuamos.
And then to that we throw the gelatin,
okay,
right?
Mientras está en la licuadora, se le agrega la gelatina derretida en agua. O disuelta en agua, mejor dicho.
All right, done.
Muy bien.
You have a cheesecake, you want to go and make a crust. So, all we're going to do is make a crust, you know, cakes like Oreo cookies. That's the unhealthy stuff, right? That makes them eat it, right?
It's okay, we can deal
so,
with that.
With the Oreo cookies, what we're going to do, we're just going to go and crush the Oreo cookies
okay.
into, make them nasty looking, right?
Como ustedes han visto,
spoon,
primero
right?
la
All right.
Bueno, la deshacen con la mano dentro de la copa.
Add a little bit of honey to it, and when we're done, it's going to look like that.
Le agregas un poquito de miel y lo mezclas, okay?
So.
Now that we have the Oreo in the glass, we're going to pour some of the mix for the mango cheesecake. Mira qué lindo. Wow. Now, once it's... We go this far, it's going to be placed in
Six
the
hours
refrigerator.
In the refrigerator.
6 horas en la nevera antes de que esté listo para comer.
If you don't have a fancy glass, we have a fancy cup.
Vamos a ver.
All right, so we made that yesterday, so it has the 6 hours in there, and you're going to tell me if you like that or not. Nothing to it, huh? Look, there's a second spoon going in, right?
Hi, I'm Christine Thomas. I'm the Director of Administration and Development here at the St. George Village Botanical Garden. And I'd like to invite everyone to come out and celebrate with us on Sunday, July 10th from noon to 6 p.m. We're celebrating the 20th anniversary of Mango Melee. Mango Melee is a festival celebrating all things mango and all things tropical fruit. And more than that, it has become a great place for friends and family to get together and have a great time. Well, this year, Mango Melee will be having some of the old favorites, the mango eating contest, the mango dis, mango dat competition, and of course, the auction of the fruit. As well as we are adding a lot of special entertainment, especially as this is the 20th anniversary. We're going to be having the Weedia cultural dancers back again since they were such a big hit last year. This year we're also going to have the Rising Stars Steel Pan Orchestra. We're going to have the Guardians of Culture, Moko Jumbies, are going to be with us. Reggae star Tia will be presenting for us. And we're also going to have Kiki and the Flaming Gypsies, who will be doing classes for the children in hula hooping as well as performing for us. And I'm also excited to introduce a new character who is called Mandy Mango, and she's going to be entertaining the children. So I'd like to invite everyone to come out on Sunday, July 10th and celebrate the 20th anniversary of Mango Melee.
Amigos, ha sido un programa maravilloso, muy divertido. It has been such...
Wait, where are you going?
I'm going to finish the show
because
we are done.
Sorry, we're not finished yet.
We are not finished.
No, we're not finished yet. You think you're going to get away that easy? We have a mango eating contest between you and I.
I never run away from contests.
If you lose, you have to buy me lunch. How's that?
Deal. Okay? Let me see. Wait.
Mira, a ver, ¿cuál tú quieres? Cualquiera de los dos. Ese, está bien.
All right. Vamos. 1, 2, 3.
I'm done. Sorry. I'm done.
Always late, always taking the shortcut. You are buying lunch. Amigos, gracias por haber estado con nosotros. Hasta la próxima.
Hasta luego, nos vemos. Chévere, cuídense. Te gané, me debes almuerzo.
Ya está aquí.